Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. If you've been here before, thanks for coming back, and if you're new, thank you for coming to me for the first time, and I hope you will consider subscribing. Today I'm going to do a colour and chat. I haven't done one for a while, and I'll get into that when we start doing it. And we're going to colour in this book, which is Dunkelbunt by Sarah Richter. It's her first colouring book. Just had a flip through of it, and I want to do this page. This picture is called Midnight. So I just think it's gorgeous. I think the entire book is stunning. So yeah, I'm just gonna change the angle of the camera so I can get in a bit closer to the bit I'm doing, which is this. It's quite a big colouring book, so there's gonna be several adjustments as we get through it, but we'll start here. So I'm going to start. I'm using my Faber-Castell Polychromos today. I'm in love with these at the moment. So, yeah. So, first of all, how are you all? I hope you've all been well, and I hope you haven't missed me too much. I'm sure you haven't. There's plenty of other great content, colouring content on YouTube without me joining in. But yeah, so the last few weeks have been really odd. I've not been well. I've had about sinusitis. I was actually off work with it. It was so painful. I've also started with a new department in my place. I still am on the other department, but I'm on loan to another department while they're so busy. I'm very short-staffed. It's just that you have to have a particular level of security clearance for the job, and not many staff members have it, so I'm actually really enjoying it. There's a lot of new stuff to learn, but that's good. Keeps your mind going, blows the cobwebs away, as it were. So Paul's downstairs today, he's got today off. I'm actually filming this in the afternoon. It's so nice not to be doing this late at night, so I can do other things at night, like watch a movie or read. See, I've had really bad sinusitis with antibiotics for a week, and while I was on them, I was feeling very foggy headed as well. Now I've finished them and I'm all right. I don't feel too bad. I feel much, much better. So, you know, I mean, it's all go at the moment. What's going on in Ukraine, which is terrible. And I don't want to talk about that because I'll just cry. Everything's setting me off at the moment. I don't know why. I just want to cry. I seriously do. About a lot of things. I think I'm just a bit, you know, very emotional when it comes to things like that. I don't like it. It's scary, too scary. So as you know, I've still been doing the weekly vlogs, which I've been enjoying, and they'll carry on. They're not going to stop. Obviously last week's wasn't a very good one, and I'm also finding it very hard to stay up late now. I'm getting so tired. You know, I'm getting older. I can't stay up as late. So, and I don't want to. And I find I want to relax and read in the evening. So, what I'll probably do is have one of my. I mean, at the moment we're trying to clean the house. Do a deep clean on the house, and I'll tell you why in a bit. I've got Tuesdays and Thursdays where Jennifer's in school till 3, or in nursery till 3 o'clock. And Friday, but Fridays I take my dad shopping to help him out because he hasn't got a car. So, and I'm happy to do that. But with my Tuesdays and Thursdays, I'm going to have to sort of split it up and do filming on one day and eBay on another, because I'm not doing any eBay. And in April, I really want to start working at it again once we hit the new tax year. I'm not worrying too much about it at the moment, but when we hit the new tax year, I really want to start doing it. And I have got stuff to list. I've got a ton of stuff to list. I've got photographs that I can get listed. You know, I've got the photographs done. I've got measurements done on clothing. I've got a load of clothing that needs photographing. I've got to sort out my light. That's a job for this weekend. But I want to get it done so I can start earning money again on eBay properly, and saving it up for more stock and just general, because at the moment I'm just treading water. I'm not making any money even though I'm selling stuff, because it's going all out in fees So whereas a couple of years ago I made £1,000 profit, the last 2 years I haven't, what with the pandemic. So, but that's just one of those things that we have to deal with. And I'm still making TikTok videos. If you're interested, I've got two accounts. I've got AndreaLife123 and Marilyn and Me. Obviously, Marilyn and Me is just about Marilyn and me and the stuff I get, what I think and my opinions, and to try and educate people, because I know a lot of people still think she was murdered. I mean, there is no evidence that she was murdered. Even one of the proponents of a lot of the conspiracy theories regarding the Kennedys, Anthony Summer, says, I don't think she was murdered. I think she killed herself. Now, he does put that down, that she killed herself because of the Kennedys, but at least he's not purporting that she was murdered by them. It's only because there's a new documentary series coming out on Netflix, which is based on Anthony Summers' biography, Goddess, which originally came out in 1985. But he has got a new version coming out with updated information. And I do wonder what that is. But at the moment, the paperback is priced at £17. For a paperback! You're having a giraffe for a book that's not even that good. So, and I must admit that I have gone through everything. I've believed all the different theories from time to time, apart from aliens. That's just being a bit too silly. You know, I have gone with the, oh, it was suicide. No, it was murder. It was an accident back to suicide. So, and I agree, we'll never 100% know, because she's dead and she's really the only one who can tell us what happened. So really, I prefer to celebrate her life and her work than focus on her death. But unfortunately, that is something we've got to do because people expect it. And with regards to that, I am starting a new series on my TikTok called Let's Talk About. Now, this is going to be about anybody or anything about Marilyn. And the first episode is going to be about Robert Slater. I've got to film it, obviously. But it is ready in the sense that I've done... I mean, you've got 3 minutes, so... you can pre-record them and upload up to 10 minutes. But the whole point of TikTok is it's fast. So what I'm going to do is just give a basic biography, what that person's claimed, why what they've claimed can't be true, etc, etc. And just, or why it might be true, you never know. And we'll work from there. So it's just a matter of me getting it filmed, which will be the first one tonight. Now, when I did the Bombshell video about the book Bombshell by Mike Rothmiller, I filmed 15 episodes in one night and put up 15 videos in one go, which is okay. You can do that. You can upload up to 300 videos in a day. Who's got time for that, though? I mean, you keep getting messages, monetize. Yeah, you need 1,000 subscribers or followers like you do on YouTube. Well, 10,000, I'm not even sure. I think it's 1,000. Makes sense. You know, I'm nowhere near 1,000 on either of them. I'm heading towards 300 on the one, which is fine. And the Marilyn one, nowhere near, but that's more my... That's a vanity project for me. That's my I want to do this. And I'm not really looking at what I'm doing because I'm concentrating. So, we're doing a deep clean downstairs at the moment. We will do upstairs as well. It is that time of year, isn't it? Let's be honest. And we are hoping in the near future to get a new kitchen and bathroom. Now, we desperately, desperately need it. So, the kitchen and bathroom were here when we moved in 10 years ago, nearly 10 years ago now. And it's just, the kitchen's falling apart. We've got cupboard doors falling off. We've got drawer panels falling off. Trim's pulling away. And we need a new one. So fingers crossed we'll get it all done. Hopefully soon. And with the bathroom, it just needs redoing. It all needs ripping out and starting again. So I'm assuming I'll do the bathroom first so we've got a usable toilet. At least I hope. And then we'll worry about, where's her leg? Oh, it's up there, isn't it? Because she's sitting cross-legged. It's really hard to see on this book when you're doing it. And of course, it's got, there it is. It's just me talking to myself now. So we're going to get a few people in and get a few quotes. We're going to get rid of our tumble dry and washing machine and get a washer dry combined, a combi one, because we just don't have a lot of space. Our kitchen is tiny. At the moment we've got a tumble dryer in the bathroom, but when Jennifer starts bathing on her own, which is a few years yet, but you know, it will happen, or she's got friends round, if they start like lobbing water at each other, it could cause a problem. So we're going to get rid of that and get one that does both and just do the washing throughout the week. So if everybody puts their dirty washing straight in the machine or in a basket in the bathroom, I can get it done every other day. Obviously the weather's improving. Today's a beautiful day. I actually got up earlier this morning, and I have to do it earlier, and put a washing on the line. So I got up, instead of getting up at 20 past or half past six, depending on how I feel, I got up at 10 past, and that gave me, I usually get up at half past, so if I, it gives me 20 minutes to put the washing out on the line. So I did, I got the washing out on the line to dry. It's a gorgeous day out there. It's probably dry already, and if I've got a load of washing later, when I put all the dirty washing in the machine, I'll put it on again tonight through the night when it's quieter. It's cheaper in the night, the energy is cheaper, and I will then put it out again in the morning. So it's not supposed to be as nice next week, which is a shame. Not as hot, and it's supposed to rain, I think, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So again, we'll be back to the tumble dryer then if necessary. And that's fine, because that's the whole point of having it. You know, you don't have a tumble dryer for the sake of having a tumble dryer. It's there to use. But I don't, you know, see the point in not using it if we need to. So, neighbour's going away to their caravan. Obviously, she's still not next door. They still haven't even started renovating her property after the fire. And the fire was in November. It's ridiculous. I feel so bad for her. Her son's so unsettled. He's acting out now, because he hasn't got his own room, his own space properly. I mean, he has got a room, but it's not his room. So it's hard on the kids. And he is a good lad. Most, 9 times out of 10, he is a good boy. He's a lovely lad. He'd do anything for you. You know, so. And I think he's unsettled, bless him. And I don't blame him, I'd be the same. So something's going on with him. But he'll be alright, he'll pull through. He's a good kid, he's got a good mum. And I miss my neighbours, because they are brilliant neighbours. So I'm just putting a darker colour on the shape where it's shaded, and lucky there is a bit of shading on this. It's not complete grayscale, but there is a little bit, and I'm just putting a slightly darker colour on there, so it will look a bit more. And some here. Some here. So, you know. So I'm really hopeful. I have said to my mum about going down and using their kitchen while we're waiting for ours to be renovated, you know, when they're working, because it's a disaster. It'll be a disaster zone. And they're only down the road. It won't be so bad. I'm not going to live on takeaways while they do it, because that costs a fortune. At the moment, with cost of living increases, it's all about trying to save money, not spending it. I like this. I think this is a gorgeous picture. But I do like Sarah Richter's art in general. So I watched an old movie last night. I've got an old movies app on my phone, my tablet, and I put it on our Android TV last night, and basically all it is it's just an app, and it locates movies on the net and directs you to them, and you can watch them. So I watched Royal Wedding last night from 1951 with Fred Astaire, and it's actually holding on YouTube, but it and the site directed me to it, and I really enjoyed it. I have watched a few films on there, and I might watch another one tonight. Because I do love my old movies, but I do want to do my TikToks. My TikToks? There we go. There's my bit more here. That's it. That's that one. Oh, I'm so tired, I will admit it. It's been a busy few days, I'm not going to lie. With work and everything, learning new stuff. So Jennifer finishes at 3 today, so I'm going to get her soon. And then when I've got her, come home, and I'm going to do a bit more tidying, of course, in the living room, if I can. I am so tired. This is a nice blue. This is one Prussian blue. Now, I'm going to boringly do a bit of the background now and see what this colour looks like. That's nice. That is a gorgeous blue. Pencils go down well on this paper, on this book, I'll admit. It's a lovely book. Oh yeah, look at that, look how easy that goes down. That is so beautiful. I'll just do a little bit of this, I'll just check, I've got to keep an eye on the time, you see. So, wow, I've already done 17 minutes. Another 10 minutes and then I'll go get Jen, so I'll do a bit more of this later on as well. I don't curse through her hair really. So the fair is in town, and the fair consists of about 3 or 4 rides. 3 adult rides normally and 2 children rides. If we're lucky there'll be a few games. Food stand, and that's about it. And the ice cream van comes down for the day, which is always nice. But we don't know yet. Jennifer wants to go to that, but there's hardly anything there. That'll be Saturday, which is cheaper than going to Newport because she'll want toys and things. As she's 4, she sees things, she wants them, doesn't she? They all kids do. So, that's nice. Like I said, I can't believe I've spent 17 minutes just doing her skin. It's going to take a long time to do this one. Oh my god, I'm falling asleep. I am so, so tired. I don't know what colour to do a dress. I could do it blue, or I could do it red. I mean, I don't want it all blue. It's ripped. I think I might go for a light, this blue. Because this is a nice blue. Let's just give it a quick sharpen. I like the polychromos. I think they're one of the nicest pencils I have got. And because I've got the complete set, I only need to replace them every now and again, don't I? So is that gonna be too much blue? I don't think so. But Jennifer would say you can never have enough blue, to be honest. That's her favourite colour. So. Oh, I am tired, mind. Oh, it's awful. So Friday tomorrow and it's weekend, and next week I've got Thursday, Friday off to do some tidying, cleaning, whatever needs doing. Get it done. I'm just looking at the colours now. I'd say that one's, yeah, that one's darker, that's fine. Keep an eye on the time. So yeah, I'm cutting down what I'm spending on colouring supplies. I've got a few bits this month, but not that much. And obviously a few books, this was quite an expensive one, but I really like it. And because I've got so many books, I'm trying to cut down on buying both reading books and colouring books so I can try and use them. I've got so many books that I have not coloured in. It is ridiculous, and I need to crack on with it, because it's hard work. I like to collect them and then I get overwhelmed by how many WIPs I've got or how many books I've got that haven't been used and aren't in the right order, so they're mixed up and they're not where they should be. Whereas if they were, that light is blinding me, I tell you. Let's push it down a bit now. It's just when it's on the cover, it bleaches out the light. So no, I like this book. I'm glad I don't mind paying that for it, because the quality of the paper, I think you could probably get away with using paint on here, watercolour. I might even try it on one of them. I might try that on the Winter's Tale. Yeah, there's a lot to do on this page yet. Oh, it's so nice. So it's going to be a lot of blue on the background on there, and I'll probably give it like a really contrasting hair colour, which will either be blonde or red. Haven't decided yet. And then we've got all the greys and stuff and stone colours around here. I've got to go and get Jen. I will be back and we'll carry on with this when it... Okay. So I'll do a little bit more. I'm not going to do too much. It's now later in the evening and Jennifer's asleep. And I've got some other things I need to do. I forgot to bring my drink up because I'm an idiot. So yeah, I like this colour. That's layering it. So we did a bit more cleaning. Bathroom's done, and most of the kitchen. Still picking up loads of rubbish in the living room. Jennifer's toys are everywhere. Don't know how many times I put them away. They always end up back, and I'm not feeling too well tonight. I don't know. I think the anxiety's got to me somehow. Still reading loads. Reading a book. Just finished a book called Nothing to Fear by Karen Rose. It was a good one. Started it yesterday, finished it today. What am I going to do next? I don't know. I've got a Peter James one. It's a small one, so I might read that in bed tonight. like I said, I am feeling a bit of colour, so I think I'll be going to sleep fairly soon tonight. Let's just change the battery again. There we go. So yeah, I'm just going to colour this in. Anything happened since I broke up? No, Jennifer's fine. She fell over in the kitchen. She had no socks on and she was running, or no shoes and socks on. And the floor gets really slippy, the tiles in there. But she's fine. She's asleep in bed now, bless her heart. She'll stay like that now, hopefully all night. I just feel a bit rough today. I think I twisted my knee and it's really painful. Going up and down the stairs is the worst, so that's fun. Obviously, I have to go up downstairs to go to the bathroom when I need to go. Let's see how dark this other blue is going to be up against this blue. It's quite blue. It's a nice darker shade. A bit too much blue, but yeah, I quite like that. I haven't finished with this yet anyway, so. It's a bit too blue. I might do the background a different colour. Take that blue off. Go over it with black or something. Yeah, that might be better. I know that, to be honest, I know this hasn't been a very long video, but I'm feeling really rotten, not feeling very well at all. So I think I might actually call it a night. I'm actually feeling a bit sick. But this is what we've done so far. So I'm going to take out this blue here. It's only that little bit and a tiny bit down there. And go over it with black. But I haven't got an eraser up here at the moment. I only got a normal one. So it's not as good as the... Well, it's coming off though. I don't want to take off too much of like a skin and stuff. That's fine. If I go over it with a black, it'd probably be all right. I'll get the Derwent one, I think, and take this out and do the black in there instead. Once I get the Derwent one, it won't get it all off. It probably won't get much off more than that, but so let's get the black out and have a look and see how well it will cover it. I'll be sick. Yeah, not feeling too brilliant today, so hopefully it'll be better tomorrow. Let's just have a look if we'd go with the black. Yeah, that'll be alright, won't it, I think. That's only the first layer, like. Let's put a bit on the white section so we can see how it looks. I think that'll be alright, don't you? Yeah. So yeah, I'm going to grab Peter James Attenborough, which is a short book. Probably 200 pages, I would say, for that. Yeah, that'll be fine. We'll just go over that with that. It'll look better. Yeah, that's fine. Well, yeah, like I said, I'm not feeling 100%, so... I have been feeling very down lately. I think it's just all... Everything that's going on in the world is so depressing. But hey, you know, the cost of living's rising everywhere, and it's just hard work for us all to make ends meet, and it's very, very hard. I'm at the moment at a point I just want to cry at anything. I see a cute animal, I'll cry at it. I'll see something sad on the TV, I'll cry on it. I'll see the bombing in the Ukraine, and I'll cry. Everything is making me cry. It's just overwhelming at the moment with everything that's going on. I just don't think I could cope with much more. So I think that it's very hard to sit back and watch what's going on. We can't do anything apart from support them as much as we can with aid and charity. And I know some people can open their homes. Ours isn't big enough. I know some people worry about bringing strangers into their home, but most of these are going to be scared women and children who just need somewhere to live away from this horrible and atrocious war and the crimes that this madman is completing. I don't care what anybody says. I think Putin is a madman. He is absolutely off his rocker. He should be put in an asylum. Not that we have them anymore, but that's where he belongs. And you know. And while you're there, can you put in the bloody Tory government as well? Because they're a bloody disaster. They're off their bloody rockers and all. I haven't got a bloody clue. Where's Guy Fawkes when you bleed need him, eh? Not that that's the answer, but... yeah, that looks nice. That looks better. There's a few more minutes of this background and then I'm going to stop. Because like I said, I'm not feeling very well tonight. And I just need to try and get some rest, I think. Have a drink and go to sleep. Get some water. And just try and read another book. Because, you know, that's all I do. Books for everything I do these days. I don't do anything else. And colouring. And like I said, this book is gorgeous. So it's going to be fun to colour. I do like this artwork. I'm not the best colourist, but I will enjoy what I do. Yeah, I am feeling very tired and off colour. And I got work tomorrow. Oh, the joy. But it is Friday, so that's always a good thing. And I've put next Thursday and Friday off to do some tidying up and cleaning and stuff, which would be nice. I am still watching your videos. I don't comment as much on videos as I should do, really. I'm very naughty like that. I do need to comment more. That's one of the reasons I don't use pencils much anymore when I'm colouring and chatting, because it takes a long time with pencils. It's a lot more work than using, say for instance, markers, but do you know what I mean? Markers, you can do things really quickly. And, you know, I'd have coloured this background by now if I was using markers and a dress, probably her hair as well. But because I'm using the pencils, it takes a lot longer because you have to layer them. But sometimes you just want to use the pencils. Pencils are nice. Anyway, I am feeling rather rotten, so I'm going to call it a night. And what I'll do is I will do some more of this in the next current chat in the next day or so when I'm feeling a bit better. But so far, she's looking kind of cool. I like her. Thanks, everybody. I'll see you soon.